So I'm going to take Alistair out with me today, and I just want to show you before I change it that back when I had the eye candy in the summer, which was probably 2 years ago, is when I got this for my 50th. In the summer I bought this eye candy nest that you put babies into, like for the winter, and it zips off, and then you can make the neck bit tighter. And I have never ever used it. So it's look how thick and lovely it is. But the reason I want to show it to you is because I'm going to lie Alistair on it today. It does have a mattress in here, of course it does. And I think it's a memory foam one. But it feels quite thin to me. And then it's like just padded on the bottom. Just a board on the bottom for a little baby to go in. But what you can do is, yeah, this was for the eye candy raspberry. But of course it fits this eye candy as well. And I'm sure it was half price. So you can unzip it to get your baby out. But then this whole top bit, I think, unzips. So you've just got then the bottom bit. So that's what I'm going to do now. Just so he's got something a little bit more comfortable to lie on and not this great bulk around him either. And I'm going to put him on a hat. And I might actually change him. I don't know. We'll see. So I took it off. And there he is. He's just in this bit now, which is really padded. I don't think he'll get hot because this is just the pad that goes like just around. And it's just lovely. It's just fleece lined. If I lift this up and show you. It's still got the feet in it, so the foot bit is still there, but I can just pop his feet above. I mean, that's not a problem, is it? But it just makes me feel happier that he's in something that's a little bit more padded. Because I actually, as much as I love this pushchair, the Pram base, I prefer the Silver Cross Pram base, because that has got just a really lovely, thick body. But anyway, so I took that bit off, and I was going to show you that bit. Here it is now. So it just looks like a jacket, like a backless, sleeveless jacket. There you go. And so when I had it on him, I had it unzipped with this zip here. And I'm going to take a cardigan, some socks, these trousers, just in case I think it gets too hot. But at the moment, I think we've just forecast loads and loads of rain. This little onesie, and then, of course, a blanket. So there you go, mate. You're going on your very first outing. Oh, and I've put this little toy thing all the way around the side. He absolutely loves this. I put it in his little crib, and it gives him something to look at. You know, they first see in mono. Babies first see in mono, so that is really good. And it has got colour on the back. But there we go. Doesn't he look cute? Morning, everybody. It is Friday. Yeah, Friday in July. First Friday in July. So what does that make it? Second? I'm running errands today because I didn't get out on Tuesday because there were awful floods in parts of Somerset. And where I go and have counselling and swimming club, they're flooded. So there were huge floods over in that area. And, you know, I don't have to worry about floods anymore. Yay! I just have to worry about falling down the hill. If I didn't have something to worry about, there would be something wrong with me, I'm telling you. Anyway, so the errands that I was going to do... Oh, hay fever nose. Just took me hay fever tablet.
Here is little man. It's a bit bright out. I mean, it's cloudy, but it's quite bright and it's quite warm. So, anyway, you've been to this area with me before. This is just because it's close to the skip that I wanted to go to. And I need to go to Home Bargains because they're the only store that stock the talc that I use for my psoriasis. And it's a pound a tub. It's a pound a tub, but if I got it off of Amazon, it would be, it's £10 for three, plus on top, £2.99 postage and packaging. So seeing as I've got other jobs to do, like shopping, I'll go to Sainsbury's and do my shopping. And take little man with me. Isn't he cute? Look at him, aunties, how well he fits in there. Look at him. I think what we'd do, there's a charity shop here. Let's go and have a look at the charity shop, shall we? And, what else? Oh, there's Next. But I don't want anything from Next, all right? So don't go encouraging me when I get to Next, please. I know what you like. You all encourage me to buy stuff when we get to Next. So here we go. It's Card Factory. It's a really good shop, actually, for cards and gifts. Really neat shop. Costa Coffee. Don't video anybody in there. Okay, here we go. This is the cancer research shop. Next to it is the pet shop. I think I'll go in there because I haven't been in that one before. So I'll go in the Cancer UK now. Anyone need any boots? Any 1970s disco boots? Got plenty here. Oh, little man there. He was so sweet. So this is quite a big, well, this is a very big charity shop for us, or a thrift store, because we tend to have lots of little small ones around here. I've been to a few bigger ones with Sheena before up in Norfolk. So it's nice to see them starting to come down here. Always come and look at the bags. I have an attraction to bags. I used to have when I was at work, lots and lots of bags. And the bag that I'm showing you there, I also got in a charity shop. So yeah, I do like bags, but they do have to be in a really, really, really good condition, just like the clothes. But I was looking at the snowsuits. Oh, just love them. Love seeing the babies wrapped up in the snowsuits there. That blue one was lovely. It's really nice. And the reason you're getting a voiceover is because they played ridiculously loud music in there. Excuse me, I've got hay fever. And I'm looking at this, thinking about Frankie, and then I didn't pick it up. Completely forgot about it. It's really funny because now I'm watching myself. I'm like, oh, you forgot to pick that up. You were going to have that. But I did give myself a £10 limit to spend in here. And the toy section was quite big. Timothy would definitely, there was a few things there I thought Timothy would definitely like. I did have to have a really good look along the toys. These little buildings are really neat for all their little characters they have, I always think. And that one kind of reminded me of Postman Pat's. Always got to have a good old look. You never know, you might miss something. It's really neat and really worth the money.
I thought to him, if he liked that truck and that truck. I didn't get either of those though. I will show you the haul, but I'm going to show it in a separate video. And along the back wall, they had all the little trinkets, all the little, all the knickknacks, as I call it, all the crockery and ornaments and ovenware, all sorts of stuff. And, you know, I really love looking along here. I like 1970s bits. And it's starting to get busy, as you can see now. When I first come in, you've seen that me pan over the whole place. And there was next to nobody in the store. Well, it's just got busy now. And so it started to freak me out a little bit. These are new items. So sometimes these charity shops get donated new items. That looked really interesting. I don't know what it is, but it looked really interesting for my hillside cottage. So I come back around this way to have a look along here. I liked how they grouped it all as well, because it's kind of like in colours. I really like that orange and green, the yellows. All the stuff of the 70s is just right up my alley. That vase there is really nice. So there we go.
Into the pet shop. Shall we, little man? It's warming up now. Might have to just put him on his vest, because it is warming up now. Nice and cool in here. Anyway, wild bird seed. Oh, no, I don't want that. I think I got enough wild bird seed. Should we have a look at the birdies at the bottom? Anybody want to buy birdies or guinea pigs? Little guinea pigs. I know they're in cages, but don't worry, they get rotated very, very quickly. The birds at the top. My dad had birds. Got rat. My brother had rats. One of my brothers. The one that I grew up with. Stinky, smelly things. Oh, it's okay. Don't be scared, bunny. There's the bunnies. Don't be scared. Don't be scared. You don't have a lot of room in there, do you? He's having a drink, let. And then we've got fish. My ex-husband had fish. Lots and lots of fish. So don't worry about them being in there. They do rotate regularly. Okay, gotta go back now. I was gonna go into next, but I have to be home by 1 p.m. today because I've got B. Why my daughter's move. My eldest daughter has to move house. So she is, yeah, moving this weekend. She was meant to move last weekend, but the tenant in the house hadn't moved all his stuff, so they couldn't move their stuff, so it was a right faff. So I had B last weekend as well. But it's just easier for them, because she's all anxious because of all the boxes, and they're going to be moving stuff, and they don't want a little doggy in the way.
So I'd better go and do that because it's 11 o'clock now. I got to be home by 1. It's half an hour drive from here. And I've got to go grocery shopping. Oh my days. Let's take a quick trip to Home Bargains. So I decided I'm not going to go to Sainsbury's. I'm going to go to Home Bargains and then the food warehouse when these cars decide what they're doing. I've come in here for the talk and I don't think they've got any. Darn, darn, darn. So there we go. Now I'm going into food warehouse because I can't wait. I can't go into Sainsbury's because I just might have the time to snip in here now. Okay, let's get some shopping from here. So this store is just full of freezers. It's like frozen food and fresh food. More and more fresh food is... time has gone on with this store. It used to be just frozen. But anyway, I'm going to put you away because I've got to get a whiz round here quickly. There we go, done the shopping. Yeah, thanks for joining me. It's all best not nice shopping alone. Do a lot of stuff alone. So yeah, it was nice to have some company today. Oh no, where's the baby? Well, I had to leave the baby in the van because I couldn't fit him in anywhere. I was just going in those two shops and I got enough time now to go home before B gets dropped off. So yes, and the most important thing on my list was my special talcum powder and I didn't find any, so I'll have to get that on Tuesday when I have counselling and fat club. So I'll have to do it then. Go into another little town to get it. It's such a pain. I know, but I know I can get it on Amazon, but I just refuse to pay the prices on Amazon. Like, it's £1 a bottle. And I usually buy loads of bottles. And the reason I'm out so quick is because I gave one to my eldest daughter. I mean, she has to dress up, gown up every day for her nursing. So, poor girl, so she gets hot and sweaty. Little man's safe in there, look at him, he's safe in there. Don't worry, I will put the cover on as well. So there we go. Oh gosh, get home in time for the dog. Happy days. There we go, see you in a bit, folks.